Now, guys, we are going to talk about the last concept for the day. That is the equation of bisector of angles between two planes. Okay. Everyone is here? Everyone is attentive now? This is the last concept?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, between two planes, let's say I'm drawing these two thin planes. Okay. The angle that is created, so there are two types of angle. One is the acute angle, another is the obtuse angle. Okay. So through these two planes, passing through the line of intersection of these two planes, I can make a bisector plane like this, okay, which bisects the angle. So this is getting bisected, okay. Or I could also have a plane that is a green plane like this, okay. This plane bisects the external angle, fine. So these two are your bisector planes. Let me call it as B1 and B2 planes. So now, if the two equations of pi1 and pi2, that is the planes which are whose angles are getting bisected, are provided to us, how do I get the equation of the bisector planes? So let's say I give you the equation of the two planes. How do I get the equation of the bisector planes? Any idea?
Equate the angles made by...
But don't you think that's a difficult way to get it? There is an easier way to do it.
It's very long.
Yeah, that'll be very long. See, very simple. I'll just draw their cross-section view. So let's say these are the two planes. Okay. And you're looking for the equation of these bisector planes, correct? Can I say bisector planes are locus of such points which are equidistant from these two planes? So this and this distance should be equal. Similarly, this and this distance should be equal. Yes or no? So we already know the equation. We already know the formula for distance of any point. Let's say I take any generic point, H, K, L. Okay, so can I say the distance of this point from pi1 and pi2 planes must both be equal?
Okay, now we got it.
Now you got it. So you can say a1h, b1k, c1l plus d1 mod by under root of a1 square, b1 square, c1 square will be equal to mod a2h, b2k, c2l. Plus d2 by under root of a2 square, b2 square, c2 square. Correct. Now drop the mod from both the sides and generalize it by replacing your h with x, k with y, and l with z. So you'll end up getting the equation as a1x, b1y, c1z plus d1 by under root of a1 square, b1 square, c1 square is equal to plus minus a2x, b2y, c2z plus d2 by under root of a2 square, b2 square, c2 square. Is that clear? Yeah. Now plus minus means there are two equations possible, thereby giving you both the equations of bisector b1 and b2. But the problem is, how will I know which is B1 and how will you know which is B2? That's something which we'll discuss in some time. Okay. Meanwhile, just a quick question on this so that you are comfortable with this concept. Please note this down because I'm switching to the next board. Let me know once done.
Yes, sir.
Done? We'll do the first part of this question first. Find the equation of the bisector of the angles of these two planes. and specify which plane bisects the acute and which plane bisects the obtuse. We'll take that later on.
Sir, done, sir.
Done?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, I'm directly writing the result. This by under root of this will be 3. As I told you, this figure is quite popular. Plus minus. And this will be by 7, right? Now cross multiply. Take a plus sign first. So take a plus sign first. You'll end up getting 14x minus 7y plus 14z plus 21 is equal to 9x minus 6y plus 18z plus 24. Bring it to one side, it becomes 5x minus y minus 4z is equal to 3. So this is one of the bisectors. Now take a negative sign. You'll end up getting 14x minus 7y plus 14z plus 21 minus 9x plus 6y minus 18z minus 24. On simplification, it gives you 23x minus 13y plus 32z plus 45 equal to 0. This is another bisector. Cool. Now, how would I know which bisector is the acute angle bisector, which is the obtuse angle bisector? Now, for that, you can use multiple things. You take one of the bisectors and you take one of the given planes. So let's say you pick up one of the original planes given to you, pi 1, and you pick one of the bisectors, b 1. Okay. Now, find out the tan of the angle between them. You can always find the cos of the angle, right? For any two planes, we can always find the cos of the angle between the planes. Convert that cos to tan. Okay. So let's say you got this angle alpha and tan alpha mod happens to be greater than 1. Right? If it is greater than 1, that means the bisector you had chosen was the obtuse angle bisector. And if tan alpha is less than 1, that means the bisector that you had chosen was the acute angle bisector. Is that clear? Now, how is this one important over here? See, if it was an acute obtuse angle bisector, alpha would have been greater than 45 degrees, right? So tan alpha would have been greater than 1. That's how. If that angle was acute angle, if that angle were acute angle, then alpha would have been less than 45 degrees. So tan alpha would have been less than 1. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
Now, many a times they ask you a very targeted question. They will say, find the equation of the obtuse angle bisector of these two planes. So many people think that finding both the equations is just a waste of time. So can I have a direct algorithm or a formula by which we can jump to the equation that we need directly rather than finding both the equations and then figuring it out which is what? Okay. So I have an algorithm. Okay, I have a method by which you can directly jump to find the acute or obtuse angle bisector. Directly. Now listen to this formula very, very carefully because many people make a mistake in understanding it. Step number one. Write down both the equations of pi 1 and pi 2 in such a way that the constant terms have been made both positive. So please note, you should have made your d1, d2 both as positive. Okay. Let's say if one doesn't have a positive d1 or d2, what do you do to that? Multiply with a minus 1. Understood? Okay. Step number two, Find A1 A2 plus B1 B2 plus C1 C2 value. Okay. Let's say this value is K. If K is positive, then A1X, B1Y, C1Z plus D1 by under root of A1 square, B1 square, C1 square with a positive sign in between. With a positive sign in between, would represent a obtuse angle bisector. Understood?
Yeah.
And if K is, yeah, and the one with a negative sign will automatically become, I'm not writing the whole thing, will become the acute angle bisector. Got it?
Yes.
If K is negative, then negative sign in between will become the obtuse angle bisector. Okay. And the same thing with a positive sign in between will become an acute angle bisector. Are you getting my point? So how do I remember this? I have a mnemonic for this. Positive means positive will be obtuse. Negative means negative will be obtuse. So whatever the sign of K, the same will be the sign to be used for obtuse angle bisector. Okay. So K positive means positive sign to be used for obtuse angle bisector. K negative means negative sign to be used for obtuse angle bisector. That's how I remember it.
Yes.
Understood. So one quick question on this.
So for the last one, the negative one will be accurate, is it? For last question.
For the last question I gave you.
Yes, sir, the second part.
Okay, we'll take that question itself. Fine. Guys, one more important thing that I wanted to tell you. Many people make a mistake there. Let me go back to the board number 31. See here, once you have made your D1, D2 as positive, okay, you should use your new equation everywhere. Means everywhere means in finding the final answer. So here your new equations will be used, not the old ones. Are you getting my point? It's better to discard the old equation. The moment you have made your D1, D2 positive, just cancel out the previous equations. So you have to work with your new equations everywhere, remember. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear.
Okay, don't start using your old equations at this step. That would make it wrong. Everything will go wrong. Okay, fine. Now, going back to the previous problem. Let's say I want to find the acute angle bisector. So first I will do D1, D2 positive. Oh, thankfully D1, D2 is positive already here. So there's no need to make any change to the equation. So these are your new equations also. Okay. So here D1 and D2 are. Okay. Then find A1, A2. A1, A2. B1, B2. C1, C2. That's positive. Okay. So Positive means with a positive sign, acute angle bisector will come. Obtuse angle bisector will come. And with a negative sign, acute angle bisector will come. So the acute angle bisector, if you want, so you can directly write. With a negative sign, guys. Okay. So if you simplify it, I'm sure you know the answer. What is that? 23x
minus 13y plus 32z plus 45.
Okay, so this one will be your acute angle bisector. Okay, and the other one, which was 5x
minus y minus 4z is equal to 3.
This one will be your obtuse angle bisector. Okay. So one last concept which is remaining, let me take that up quickly. Position of two points with respect to a plane. Hardly will take me 2-3 minutes. Of two points with respect to a plane. So if you have been given a plane, let's say AX plus BY plus CZ plus D equal to 0. How do I know whether the two points A and B, okay, whether they lie on the same side or whether A and B lie on the opposite sides of the plane? Okay, so let's say A is given by X1, Y1, Z1, B is given by X2, Y2, Z2. Okay, how do you know it's lying on the same side or on the opposite sides? Okay. Now, the method for this is basically very simple. I'll just discuss the result with you. Put this point in the plane. So AX1, BY1, CZ1 plus D. Evaluate this number and evaluate the value of this also. So both these points you put in the plane. Okay. If these two are of the same signs, okay, then both are on the same side. And if these two are of opposite signs, if these two numbers are of opposite signs, then they would lie on the opposite sides. Is the idea clear? Now, how does this come actually? Very simple. If the points are on the same side, then what will happen is, if the points are on the same side, what will happen? The plane will externally divide the join of these two points, isn't it? So this point C will externally divide the join of A and B. So there's an external division happening here. Okay. Whereas if they're on the opposite side, the plane will internally divide the join of A and B. Are you getting it? So here, if I assume this ratio to be lambda is to 1, okay, and here is to be lambda is to 1, the lambda here will come out to be negative, lambda here will come out to be positive. Okay, so let me express the lambda first. So position of the point C could be written as, x1 plus lambda x2 by lambda plus 1, y1 plus lambda y2 by lambda plus 1, and z1 plus lambda z2 by lambda plus 1, isn't it? Now lambda would be negative, positive, that is something which I'll take care later on. So as of now, what I'm taking this point C coordinate to be x1, this is your, let's say, this was your x2, y2, z2, right? Okay, and this was your x1, y1, z1. Yeah. So I've taken it to be lambda is to 1, isn't it? Okay. So the coordinates of C would be 1 into x1, lambda into x2 by lambda plus 1, likewise. Now this should satisfy. This should satisfy AX plus BY plus CZ plus D equal to 0. So when I put this point, it will become A, x1 plus lambda x2 by lambda plus 1, b y1 plus lambda y2 by lambda plus 1, and c z1 plus lambda z2 by lambda plus 1 e, plus d equal to 0. Multiply throughout with lambda plus 1, so it becomes a x1 plus lambda x2 y1 plus lambda y2 c z1 plus lambda z2 plus d lambda plus d equal to 0. Take all the lambda terms together, so it becomes a x2 b y2 c z2 plus d is equal to negative a x1 b y1 c z1 plus d. So lambda is negative a x1 b y1 c z1 plus d by a x2 b y2 plus c z2 plus d. Now for internal angle bisector, for external angle bisector, lambda should be negative. If lambda is negative, that means this quantity itself should be positive. Correct? Let me call this quantity as beta. Beta should be positive. Okay? If beta is positive, means both the numerator and denominator must be of the same sign. That's what I wrote over here. Getting my point? Similarly, if lambda were to be negative, lambda were to be positive, that means this quantity beta has to be negative. And if beta has to be negative, it means these two quantities must be of opposite sign. Correct? These two must be of opposite sign then. Correct? That's what I wrote over here. Is the idea clear?
Yes, sir.
Fine then, I'll stop here. Thank you so much. We have officially completed the syllabus.